She's sort of totally made up for stuff, right? Yeah, and there's a mini generation picture with our grandmother, so that would have been Annie's mother, and then there's Christine. I can hardly recognize you. Oh my goodness. And but anyways, there's a multi-generational picture, so that is great to have been able to take that. And there she is. Oh, what did she can there? Is that tomatoes? Oh my goodness. She had enough for the neighborhood. And there's another generational picture. And, oh, okay, so the baby is Helene, is it from Virginia? Okay, oh, that's Helene herself. Okay, yes, it's that many years ago. Wow, that's amazing. Okay, and that's the famous Christmas tree. There was always, those Christmas trees were always amazing. I know, you know, our eyes just always popped when we saw them. And of course, there's Christine. Oh, that's the year she got the carriage from Germany. There's Christine on her mom's lap. Is that a birthday cake on the side there? It's a cake anyway, yeah. And what have we been, four or five? Oh, and look at the most proudest day, one of the proudest days of Christine's life, and certainly Aunt Annie too, when her daughter graduated as a nurse. Wow, what a picture. And there is my mother, so that's the three sisters there, not all five sisters, but three. So my mother is on the far right, then Lena, my sister Lena's in the middle, and then Aunt Annie Herman is on the left-hand side. Yes. Oh, and who made the sweaters? Aunt Annie made the sweaters. How beautiful is that?
In fact, I think she knit, four or five
sweaters. Those are sidewash sweaters for people that aren't familiar with them, and they're a lot of work, but they're beautiful.
Pardon?
Sure.
Fisherman, yes, yeah. That picture is worth 1,000 words. That's all I can see. Okay, and she's sort of, I'm not sure if she's going to be picked up or what she's waiting for.
That's her back
door. Oh, that's her back door, sorry. Okay, next. Okay, you know what, they all had such a good sense of humor. My grandmother did. Annie had a great sense of humor, and I think we all sort of inherited a lot of that, right? Because we love to laugh, and they love to laugh. Yeah. And there is Annie in the middle, and
Susan is on her left, and her daughter Miranda is on the right. And Susan faithfully took my mom, to church for years. She picked her up for church. They were very good friends. Pardon? From Winkler here, yeah.
Okay, what's your last name?
Weeb.
Okay, very nice.
And there is little Chantel and Jonathan on the turtle. I believe she made that turtle as well. Lots of fun on that turtle.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. Four generation with Melanie being the baby there.
So here are the three sisters. You can tell that they must have been very close. So this time my mother is on the left, my left, and then Annie's in the middle, and Lena is on the other side. And there's my mother, and so this is not, for whatever reason, Annie isn't in this picture, but we love Annie because there. Okay, here she is with her whole family at that point, right? And so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so there's a few more to come, right?
Yeah, so going from oldest to youngest, or we not do that in the picture?
Reverse.
Okay, there we go. Okay, Chantel, Jonathan, Melanie, Helene, and Rebecca's up there in Dad's arms, and little Lynn is in my arms.
Boy, they've all grown up.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow.
Okay, next is fine. Okay, so here's Grandma. Grandma's wheelchair is being used for other things than Grandma, right?
Everybody
wanted to. All right, and there's all the spoon collection. We heard she collected many different things, right? And so this was this one of the collections of spoons. Wow. Oh, and here she is relaxing with afghans around her and flowers. She loved flowers. And she's, oh, she's sewing a quilt there. Wow.
And that afghan's on the table.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. That was.
And your orchids are there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and there she is with one of the grandkids. Which one?
That's
Catherine. That's Catherine.
Christine, we can't keep track. Right?
I know.
I'm sorry.
I know.
What an. Say everybody's back every picture.
Right, right. Right. At least once.
Famous bunny birthday cake.
Famous bunny birthday cake.
At Grandma's house.
At Grandma's house.
Grandma made that.
So Annie made that.
There's a Lynn on the bear rug.
So.
A Lynn is on the bear rug. And it looks like Catherine is working on a hanger that Grandma taught them how to cover those hangers.
Oh, she used to make an awful lot of those. Oh, the pumpkins are just about as big as Annie. That's her back door. Oh, and there's some family that isn't here today, and I'm thinking
they were going to all be here, but
yeah,
the weather
didn't allow.
Numerous times this morning,
the last time I was here, they were all here.
Yeah. Okay, so Annie is on the far left, and then is Marion, Linda, Lorna, and Margie. So they are the children of the oldest sister of Annie, who has passed away many years ago already, but. They always come. They were very close to Annie, and I know they really, really would have missed being here today. Yeah. There's Annie with Catherine. No. Okay.
That's a classic. Okay, these are our three girls with cystic fibrosis as babies, or some aren't babies anymore, but anyway, they were all next in age. So there's Rebecca, Lynn, and Catherine, all and Grandma, somehow attached to Grandma there. She was very attached to her grandchildren, and she did a lot for each and every one of them.
Okay, this is somebody special day.
Stan's
son-in-law. Son-in-law, Stan, okay.
Well, not son-in-law, grandson.
Grandson, okay, there we go.
My son-in-law.
Okay, all right, and this is a very special picture. This is Annie on the left and her sister Nettie. And I know once, when they lived further apart from each other, they didn't see each other nearly as often as they would have liked to have. Because Nettie was living up in Nanaimo, BC, and different parts in BC, and so this would have been a special time for Annie to be with her sister. Oh, and there's more. There's my mother is on the left. So some of these pictures I've never seen before, so you can tell we're oohing and aahing here too. And then Nettie comes next, then is Lena, and Annie is on my far right.
Can you see the angel?
Well, the one in white, I would say.
I would think,
but they're having a good time, I can tell. Mm-hmm. Oh, and there they are in the boat. And so Annie's in the center. She's manning the ship. And Lena's on the my right, and Nettie is on the left.
And they're Hawaiian.
Oh, in their Hawaiian outfits. Oh, my goodness. And they went to Hawaii. Okay, so Annie is on my right, Nettie is in the middle, and Lena's on the left. They're sisters that loved each other a lot. Okay, and there's Annie coming off the bus, so this must have been another one of their tours that they went on. Right, and then Lena is on the other side. Yeah, right there. Okay, so here they are doing their luau, right? Yeah, and Annie is right in the middle here. Her sister is right behind her, is Nettie.
Pardon? That was her favorite game, Rummy Cube.
Oh, they're playing Rummy Cube. Okay, there we go. Okay. And there they are. That's a close up. So Annie's on, this is Rummy Cube. Annie's on the left, Nettie in the far back, and Lena on this side. So the sisters spent as much time together as they could when they visited, right? Okay, so you say who these people are.
Well, Aunt Lena's daughter, Ann, and husband, Ian. And I believe this was at their cottage.
Yeah.
I believe the boat, too, that probably would have all been taken out of their cottage. Yeah, and they stopped in and saw my mom several times on the motorcycle or whatever they were. They're in Texas, so they couldn't make it.
All right, so here is Linda is sitting in the middle in the chair. So that would be a niece to Annie. Annie is on the left, and then Nettie, the other sister, is on the right. And there is Grandma with a great-grandchild, perhaps. Is that right? The oldest great-grandchild. Linnea, okay. Oh, and here there's a feast. but then there are so many children you have to.
It's the one my dad made for the cottage years ago. It has been our kitchen table for as many years as we moved here.
Wow. There's a lot of food, that's the main thing. And there's Annie.
Left. The subtitle there is called Cruising.
Okay. Oh, that's funny. Okay, and there she is. Must have been a special day because she's got a flower, a boutonniere on there.
Somebody
got everything?
Yes.
Okay.
And, yeah, and these are the last times.
Taken on December the 10th.
On December the 10th. And that's at the graveside. Mm-hmm. Final goodbye, see?
No, see you later.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
It's a see you later.
That's right. There she is at peace. Families together. That was taken yesterday. And it's good to, like, I didn't realize exactly where she'd been interred, but now we all know so that if at some time we want to stop by, that's where it is, right?
Here the great-grandchildren were putting flowers in the coffin that they had brought for her.
Oh, that's very nice.
Yeah, that's very touching. So cool that so many of them could say, I knew my great-grandmother, right? Oh, she is. Is that David?
Yeah.
That's David.
Mm-hmm.
Really? It could crush you. That's what I hear behind me. Oh, and there she is, right, with the white hair. She had beautiful white hair, didn't she? Yeah. And that's in your kitchen, right, Christine?
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, and there's a nice family picture that would have been taken this year, I'm thinking, right? Or a year or two ago. A few years ago. Beautiful star gazer lilies, eh? Beautiful. Mm-hmm. Okay.
This is her 95th birthday?
95th birthday in May. Just a few days after my mom in May, that's when her birthday was. Oh, and there's the handshake. She's not letting go, David.
Oh,
that's pretty cool. She still had it. Oh, there, she's being Santa, Mrs. Santa Claus.
In the 90s, she was still, after the meals, where she still could, and that was till, I don't know, when the last time would have been, but maybe till a couple of years ago. She always said, the dishes are my job. I'm doing the dishes, because we didn't have a dishwasher.
Wow.
So it was up to the rest of us to do the rest. And she took care of the dishes.
There she is. She's playing pool. I think she was trying to hide that from everybody. I think she got caught.
Something behind her back.
That was the birthday party.
90th. Yes, in fact, because I was there.
What she wore at that time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that must have been maybe the 90th, when her 90th birthday was. So that would have been 5 years ago. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because that's where we were. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, her hand's shaking. Or her.
That was last year.
Her grip is.
Even these last 5 weeks, that grip was there till almost to the end. Maybe not quite as strong, but just quite as strong.
Oh, nice. And this is with Helene, right? Okay, this is her oldest grandchild? Fourth oldest. Okay. And it was taken last summer. Oh, there she is with some special people right beside her. Okay, a few weeks ago, there's David on the one side. Who's on the other?
Catherine.
This is, okay. Then it would have been November because that's when she had the start of her health problems. Okay. Next. Yeah, we've seen similar ones. Next. She's playing a special game. Oh, Revelation. Okay. She loved playing games, I think. Yeah. And there we are. That's her.
Could you do the three videos? This was 5 days before she passed away.
You are my special sweetheart. I love you. I love you so much.
Yo.
And
trying our flag.
I love your smile.
Yeah,
I love your smile. Yes, so precious.
Your
grandchildren all say hi to you. They love you so much. Yeah, Helene came all the way from Virginia, 3,000 miles, to visit you with her little baby girl. Her 4 month baby girl, she did. Mm-hmm. She's dropped in here a few times, but she's been very tired. Maybe you didn't notice her. And Rebecca's been here with her 2 month baby boy. And she loves you too. And Alyn and Eric have come to visit you. Yeah, they live 2 hours away.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Catherine and Sarah and David, of course, have come to visit you. They love you very, very, very much. Yes, they do. And Melody's come to visit you. And Chantelle has come to visit you with her girls. Stan was on the road trip. Isn't that special? You're very blessed. Yes, you are. There's many people praying for you. Yes. Yeah, they care about you. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They love you a lot.
Oh, thank you.
There's the fresh looking. Beetje. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Have you done the wrong hatch? Love you so much, Mom. Do you have a hug for me? Do you have a hug? That's a lot of work, isn't it? Hugging and kissing, right?
You don't want to bite me, because you're with
that man. Okay, you have something in your mouth that's bothering you. What is that? Okay, you got it out. Good for you. Yeah. There you go. Yeah, I have no use for that, right? Oh, your hands are nice and warm.
I know.
Special mother. Mm-hmm. Yes, you are. Mm-hmm. Glad you could have all of your supper. Isn't that good? You had some juice. Some cranberry juice, right? Maybe you want some water too. I'll have to find out where there's some water for you. Well, here's a cup of some water. I can get you some water yet. Now you're hanging on to me, right? Mm-hmm. You are strong. You're so strong from milking all those cows, aren't you? Remember? All those muscles? That you built working hard on the farm?
That was 5 days before she passed away. It was definitely definitely one of the exceptional days where she felt better than average.
So Rips, I count her in and let me count her dive. 1, 2, 3.
When anyone takes pictures, don't tell them your
secret. Hey, Grandma. Happy birthday!
Yay!
It's your birthday! You are 95! You're 95, almost 100. But not 100, you're 95. Yeah. There we go.
Memories of my grandma, whom I love very dearly. I'm living in Virginia with my husband and 5-month-old baby girl, Eliana. I'm eternally grateful that things worked out so that Chris, Eliana, and myself were able to come to Canada last minute and spend over 2 weeks with my family. During that time, I spent many hours at my grandma's side, and as my mom says, I got the most kisses. As I sat beside her, I thanked her for some of the things that she had taught me, and I shared the good times that we had had together. She sat there holding my hand and listened, although often very tired. I did get her to smile a few times when I mentioned my mom needing what my grandmother always called a punchy. It's basically like a love pat. She also smiled and said, "Oh my," when I told her that I came all the way from Virginia to visit her. When I think about my grandma Herman, I think of the strongest woman that I've ever met. I've never once won an arm wrestling contest with her, and if there was a jar that I couldn't open, no matter how hard I tried, she could always make it happen right away. Didn't even make it look like it was any work. She said that she got her muscles from milking cows by hand as a girl, and I'm inclined to believe her. One of my earliest memories of my grandma was in her house In Winnipeg, her basement had a purple lamp and smelled like mothballs. It's also the first place I remember having cottage cheese pierogies, one of my favorite foods till this day. I remember my grandma coming to visit us in Calgary when my sister Kate was born. My mom surprised her mother with a new baby girl when she got back after my dad picked her up from the bus station. She often spoke of that trip and how surprised she was. Grandma was always a very helpful lady. She would help do the dishes and really hot water, but she would also make sure that she had special time to spend with her grandchildren. She would sit down and read us stories for hours and sing songs with us or read us the Bible. And I'm ashamed to admit this, but often when she babysat us for a longer period of time, we didn't behave the best, probably making her job quite difficult now that I look back on the situation. But anyways, a few hours before my parents were due to arrive home, we would be very, very helpful and say how sorry we were. And she always forgave us and never mentioned to our parents how we had really behaved. Her favorite chocolate bars were Kit Kats, and she almost always had peppermints in her house, along with strawberry candies and Werther's caramel candies. My grandma loved to bake for people. Sometimes she would bake us 3 pies in a week. She often sent us home with icebox cookies or her famous apple pies. My grandma taught me how to make pierogies, and I always think of her when I'm making them. I have the piece of countertop here in Virginia that she would always put on the top of her table to roll them out. And my grandma was a very hard worker. In her spare time, though, she would often be found doing crossword puzzles, crocheting, and she loved to watch Jeopardy. When I have a sleepover at her place, I sleep on her bear rug, and I thought it was the coolest thing ever. My grandma sang in the choir at the church that she attended for many years, and she sang well into her 80s. She always sat in the same spot at church, and she would get there extra early to save her seat, bless her heart. She hated to be late, something I wish I had inherited. And one time, when we were running behind for church, to ease her mind, my sister Kate told her that they had changed the start time just this once for her. She often wore her native perfume from Avon, and on special occasions would let me wear it too. I'm not sure why, but she had a crazy dislike of showers. She didn't keep a shower curtain up in her bathroom. The 2 times I got to shower her place, I had to hang up the curtain first and then take it down as soon as it was dry. When us kiddos would ask her for what she was making for dinner, she always replied, no matter what she actually was really making, frog's legs. Her amazing apple fritters, she also called frog's legs. But anyways, just a funny story. Above all, I remember how much she loved her daughter, my mom. She was very, very proud of her. I will always love and respect my grandmother and hope to teach my daughter many of the things I learned from my grandma. My grandmother loved the Lord and always had her Bible beside her favorite touch lamp in her living room. I often saw her reading it, and when we would sleep over, she would always pray with us before we could go to sleep. I miss you already, Grandma, and I will see you one day on the streets of gold. I love you. Helene.
I hope you found some of that interesting. The next thing on the order of service is open mic share.